My name is Kim Guadagno. I'm the Lieutenant Governor of the state of New Jersey and also the Secretary of State. Supposed to just do a stop by, so this is my stop by. So let me answer a few preliminary questions. Let me get to your question about elections, because I think it's an important one and I happen to know the answer to that question. So it's always fun to come to a group of people where you can at least answer one question. So first, let me tell you who the Lieutenant Governor is. Many of you, you didn't miss anything. There was no Lieutenant Governor until 2009. Back in 2005, all of us decided to vote about whether or not we should have somebody replace the governor when he was otherwise unavailable. To give you some records, some reminders, you know, Christy Whitman, Governor Whitman, left a year early, and we had the head of the legislature come and run the government, the executive side, so there was an issue about whether the legislature and the executive, you guys are all in the teaching area, whether the legislature was independent and a co-equal branch, if it was also headed by, heading the executive side. So the Governor Whitman, Governor McGreevy, and then some issues about John Corzine when he was sick and was out for a long period of time. In each situation, you had the legislative branch take over the executive branch. So in 2005, constitutional amendment comes, you vote to have an election. 2009, there's an election for a governor, and in 2009, the governor now, candidate Chris Christie, invited me to run with him as the lieutenant governor candidate in 2010. I don't need to tell you, I was elected the first lieutenant governor of the state of New Jersey out of Monmouth County. Any Monmouth County? Or it's here. There you go, oh, there's some people I know, too. So, for those of you that want to know what it is I do all day, as you all probably could guess, I do whatever the governor tells me to do. But I also, because we've been on a budget a campaign of less government, for those of you that thought during the storm last year I was getting paid to be in the state and was not in the state, I in fact am not paid as the lieutenant governor. When I walked in the door, I had no salary, no portfolio, no office, no staff, no pension, nothing. And we decided when we looked around state government, the governor and I, that it would be good to have us physically close together and do something related to business, which is what the governor had promised he would have his LG do. So, I am now the Secretary of State. If you've been in the State House, it's down the hall, literally from here to the back door, down the hall, take a left and a right, and you have the Secretary of State's office. So now it's, I get paid as the, now I'm in trouble. See, I thought I was getting away without the press. It's supposed to be a stop by, that's okay. That NJN has arrived. Now I take the fifth on everything I'm about to do. See, okay? I should have told all the good stuff the first 5 minutes. Anyway, the bottom line is I am now, for those of you that are interested, the Secretary of State, for which I do earn a salary, the Lieutenant Governor, for which I do not earn a salary. So at times when the Governor is out of state, I am the Acting Governor, the Lieutenant Governor, the Secretary of State. I get one salary, no pension, and I literally get to do whatever the Governor tells me to do. As Secretary of State, though, to answer your question, I also run the Board of Elections. For the state of New Jersey, you might have heard recently some issues about ballots and who gets on the ballot and who doesn't get to stay on the ballot. Part of my job, and part of my job as the legislature has defined my job, not as the governor, but as the legislature and the Constitution has defined my job, is to supervise on a statewide basis the Board of Elections. So the proposal that's pending as part of the governor's toolkit is to merge all elections in one time period in November, because most of our big elections anyway happen in November. The idea, of course, is that we would get more people to participate in elections. Now, some people think that's a good idea, and some people think that's not such a good idea, and I'm not going to get involved in that. That's a legislative issue. That's something I hope you weigh in on, because it will save money. It does save roughly $5,000 per election per district. That's the number we've provided to the Office of Legislative Services. So in addition to accomplishing the goal of making government more transparent and making people more participate more actively in government it will also save the taxpayer money over time. And I encourage you to take a position. Take a position on that, because you are the people most affected by that. The other piece of the toolkit would be, because I know the next comeback is if we move the elections, how do we manage our budgets as school boards? Part of the legislation, as I understand it, would eliminate the vote on budgets, which is very interesting. So take a good hard look at that legislation, because I believe more people will come out and vote. I know that has implications for members of the school board. That's an upside and a downside in some situations, but it also would revise the way we do our budgets. And you might not be subject to the constant battle over what your budget's going to be. So you as administrators and managers and elected public officials will be better able to manage that budget, which is a long way of answering your question. So I am here on behalf of the governor to tell you thank you. Thank you for coming out to Trenton to learn about the process that I've spent the last 16 months studying, for better or for worse. I know a lot of you who have heard me speak have heard me tell about politics in Trenton. When you come to Trenton, there are different, there's different ways of looking at things than if you go back to your hometowns. I came from a little tiny town of Monmouth Beach, has 300 kids in the school district, 300 kids with a superintendent, a principal, and a vice principal. So I come at your job from a different perspective than maybe the larger districts do. But you need to understand what goes on here in Trenton. You need to participate in that debate. You know, we have positions. We have staked out positions. We have addressed problems. We have staked out our position on what those problems are. But we've also invited people to come back and give us some input on those positions. I have my own position. I have the governor's position. I think you guys are pretty well aware of what that position is, and I'm not going to even try to articulate it as well as the governor does, but I know this. I know this as a mother, as a parent of three kids, one of whom is graduating from a public school this year and going to the Air Force Academy, I might brag. He received a fabulous public school education. For the very first time in my life, when my kid got into a high school in Monmouth County, one of those special ones, I felt I was getting my tax dollars worth. I really was proud of the day I didn't have to write a tuition check so that this kid could get the education he needs. But I know there are people that are going to public schools that are not getting their tax dollars worth. And that's what we're here to talk about. That's what I need you to talk about. We stake out a position. This is what leadership is all about. We stake out our position. We articulate our position. And then we go and fight for our position. And I cannot think of anything more important to fight about than what you all are doing here, right here today, our kids. And we're not always going to agree. And that's our system. We shouldn't always agree. Because everybody has a role to play. Everybody has a part to play. And I know you all probably think it's really political. But let me assure you of this. What goes on in Trenton, it's like making sausage. But it really tastes good at the end. It really looks ugly at the beginning, but it tastes good when it comes out and you can eat it and it's really fabulous food. Now, why is it ugly? Because that is our system. If anybody else has a better system of government, I defy you. Define. It's our system. And I, come from a litigation background. My first job in public service was organized crime and racketeering prosecutions. My first elected public office on a countywide basis was as sheriff of Monmouth County. I carry a gun and wear a bulletproof vest because I understand how tough it can be in this political world. But that's our system. And we can do it respectfully. And we can do it nicely. And we can do it so long as we understand that that's a part of the system. So what you see in Trenton sometimes goes like this. The head of the Senate or the Assembly will go into the halls up Trenton under that gold dome and pound on his or her chest and talk about how horrible whatever we are doing the day is. And then the governor or his staff or myself will go out to a podium like this about an hour after they finish, and we'll do the same thing, and we'll pound on the table here, and we'll talk about how horrible whatever happened in the morning is. But what you need to know in this room, and this is why you're here, is that after they get it out of their system in the morning and we get it out of our system in the afternoon, everybody goes back to a table in that state house and tries to make the best decision for the people of the state of New Jersey. I believe that. I know they believe that. I know our governor believes that. And that's what you're learning here today. It is our system. It's the best in the country. It's the best in the world. And it works. Unfortunately, sometimes a little difficult. You have to be able to take criticism. But if you can't take criticism, you know what that means? That means you're doing nothing. That means you're not taking a position. So I'll take the criticism, because that's the way we do things. But I invite you to continue the partnership we have, an open, honest, reflective relationship where we can exchange ideas. Hopefully, we do a better job without these microphones right here, and I think we do. When we sit down as parents and taxpayers and residents and moms and dads and grandparents, I think we do the right thing for the people that you represent. And I'm here to tell you, thank you for that. We may not always agree, but we will always do it respectfully. And we will always lay out our position in an honest and open way. And I hope you understand that. I hope you believe that. I know I do. If you have any questions for me, I am happy to try to answer them outside of this forum. And I invite you to send me emails. I invite you to call me. And the other part of my job is not only streamlining government and speaking about businesses, but it's also to streamline red tape. And I know none of you know anything about red tape. So in terms of red tape, if you know, I know the governor has set out a couple executive orders, set up a couple panels to help deal with red tape. If you know some red tape issues you think we can fix, bring them to my attention, please. My staff is available here. And we will be reaching out to the school board's leadership to make sure that red tape comes to our attention. I thank you for the few minutes today.